Hola amigos, ya estamos en nuestro sexto trabalenguas hoy.
Today we are already in our sixth tongue twister.
Sexto trabalenguas.
Este trabalenguas también es sencillo, pero estaremos practicando con sonidos diferentes a los de los trabalenguas anteriores.
This tongue twister is also an easy one, but we will be practicing different sounds or words
than we have in the previous tongue twisters, okay?
And also, remember, in one of our first tongue twisters lessons, I taught you how the diminutives work in Spanish, right?
The ito and ita, right? The ending in ito for masculine and ita for feminine. These are the diminutives in Spanish, and Spanish uses a lot the diminutives, right?
I told you that diminutives are used in Spanish for indicating something that is small or little or few, and also to indicate fondness on something or somebody. For example, if I have a friend called Pedro, doesn't mind if he's older than me or bigger than me, but if I want to express fondness, I can address him as Pedrito, right? Pedrito. Usually, we would address somebody Pedrito if he's younger than us, usually if it's a child, but not necessarily. It can also indicate fondness, and somebody may address somebody older and bigger with a diminutive, right? Indicating love or fondness, okay?
I also told you that Mrs. is señora and Miss is señorita, right? Young or unmarried woman, okay? But that also the diminutive that means implies also fondness can be used ironically, and then instead of fondness it indicates disdain, right? So it's very interesting how diminutives are used in Spanish. And still more interesting because diminutives are used a lot in Spanish, okay? So, here in this tongue twister, we'll be using diminutives a lot again. Now look, remember that we said poco a poco means little by little, yes? Poco a poco. Poco means little, uncountable, okay? Poco a poco, little by little. Poquito a poquito is the diminutive of poco, right? Why don't we say poquito like this? Because the C changes its pronunciation if it's followed by an I. So this would be posito. Posito is something different. Posito is a small pozo. A small pozo, that means a small hole, right? A small ditch, actually, a ditch in the ground. Yes, a small ditch in the ground would be un pocito. But poco, the diminutive would be poquito with Q-U, so we keep the same sound of the K sound, okay? Poquito a poquito would be the diminutive way of saying poco a poco. So, the word little, how can the word little take a diminutive, right? If it's not an object, it's just a way of addressing something. Yes? So in this case, when that poco, that is not a noun, it's not an object, when we convert this, a word that is not an object by itself, into a diminutive, it's used to expressing, to speaking in either a childish way or a very delicate and soft and friendly way, okay? So the opposite of rude, actually very soft and very friendly and quiet way, okay, and people that speak like that usually like to speak with diminutives, right? So, poquito a poquito would be a very quiet and calm way of saying the same thing, poco a poco, and it is used in Spanish. Paquito is the diminutive of the name Paco. Paco, okay?
It's not the short form or the abbreviation. It's the diminutive that is different. Paquito, we usually mean a little child that is called Paco. We can call him Paquito, right? Empaca. Empaca is the verb empacar. El verbo empacar significa guardar algo en paquetes. The verb empacar means to pack, right? To pack something either in packages or also to pack something, you're packing down your stuff to travel, okay? So it has, I think, the same meaning as in English, okay? Same exact meaning. Empacar, to pack or to pack down, right? Poquitas copitas, again, poquitas, same as poquito, poquito, right? And copitas. Copitas are small glasses. Recuerden que en la clase pasada les enseñé la palabra copa en español. Copa is not necessarily a cup. In English we call a cup of tea, a cup of coffee, right? In Spanish, the word copa is used for the chalice type of glass, okay? For it can be a chalice, can be of metal, can be of glass, or any other material, a chalice. And it's also used, copa, for a glass of wine, a glass can be of champagne, or any kind of glass, the one that has that shape and the thin stem for taking with your fingers, right? That, in Spanish, we call una copa. And copitas is a plural for small glasses, right? Small copas. Copitas are small ones. En pocos paquetes, in few packages. We said empacar is to pack or to pack down, and paquetes are packages. En pocos is few, right? Pocos. You can see that what differentiates this from the word little is that few has an S that shows that it is countable. Pocos means few. Poco without the S means little. Masculine, right? If it were little feminine, it would be poca, right? And few masculine is pocos, and few feminine would be pocas. Bien, creo que ya nos ha quedado claro el vocabulario de este trabalenguas. I think now it's clear for us all the vocabulary of this tongue twister. Así que ahora podremos comenzar a leer nuestro trabalenguas. So now we can begin to read our tongue twister. Antes leamos el sentido todo junto. Now first let's begin to read the meaning again in English all together, right? Instead of doing it word by word. Little by little, Paquito packs down or packs the few small glasses in few packages, okay? In few packages. So poquitas and pocos means the same thing, only that poquitas is feminine, pocos is for a masculine noun, okay? And poquitas is just in diminutive, as I explained at the beginning of the lesson. Bien, comencemos a leer y tratemos de no trancarnos. Por lo tanto, comenzaremos a leer despacio. Let's begin to read and let's try not to get blocked. So let's begin reading slowly. Poquito a poquito, Paquito empaca, poquitas copitas en pocos paquetes. Poquito a poquito, Paquito empaca, poquitas copitas en pocos paquetes. Okay? This is how we would read it in read speed. Poquito a poquito, Paquito empaca, poquitas copitas en pocos paquetes. So little by little, you'll be able to read it faster or to speak this aloud faster without getting blocked or jammed, okay? De a poco o de a poquito, que es lo mismo, little by little, de a poquito, o poquito a poquito, iremos pudiendo.